Hearty welcome to all of you. I am Dr. Jayananda Swami C. Indimath, working as an assistant professor of commerce in Government First Period College, Padigi, Haveri district of Karnataka state. This is my third video about index numbers, which is part of the business statistics 2 subject of BCom 4th semester, Karnataka University, Dharwad. In this particular video, I am going to solve the 10 years previous question papers problem carrying 5 marks so that students can get the benefit of the to score more marks in their examination. So before that, if you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please subscribe. If you like the video, please click on the like button and click on the bell icon to receive the latest notification about the latest videos. Right here, from the year 2010 to 2019 question papers, out of these 10 question papers, that is previous year's question papers, the 2019 and 2017 question paper problems have already discussed in my previous video. So except these two, from the year 2010 to 2019, all the 5 marks questions are being solved in this particular video. Right, let us move towards the next slide. Here, before going to solve the question paper problem, the students needs to understand what kind of different type of problem that they may face in the examination. Here, the students may face 2 type of problems for 5 marks in their examination on the consumer price index number. The problem type 1. The problem type 1, in this problem type, the group is given, that is the food, clothing, fuel, lighting, house rent, miscellaneous, like that. And the group index is also given, that is I. And weight is also given. So only students, what they have to do is, they have to calculate IW. How? So multiply I with W, that is 550 into 46. Whatever value they get, they have to put here. And 215 into 10, whatever value they get, they have to put here. 220 into 7, 150 into 12, whatever value they get, put here. So 275 into 25, whatever the value they get, they need to put here. And total it, you will get sigma IW. And W column total, that is sigma W. Okay. Next, students need to use this formula, that is consumer price index equals to sigma IW divided by W. So this is sigma IW and this is IW. So sigma IW divided by sigma W, whatever the answer they will get, that itself is the consumer price index. So this is how the problem is to be solved. And this is one kind of problem that the students may face in their examination. And another kind of problem that may face in their examination is, that is problem type 2. This is another type of problem. See here, the group is given, weight is given. But this particular group index is not given in this particular kind of problem. So here, base year price will be given, current year price will be given. So base year price means P0, current year price means P1. Means they have to calculate I, that is they have to calculate, students need to calculate I. So to calculate I, we have to use this formula, that is I equals to P1 divided by P0 into 100. So that itself is the I. So they have to calculate I here. How? That is P1 is 200 divided by P0 P0 160 into 100, that is 200 divided by 160 into 100, whatever the value you get, you need to put here. And likewise here, 60 divided by 40 into 100, whatever value you get, you need to put here. Okay, so 50 divided by 25 into 100, whatever value you get, you need to put here. 10 divided by 4 into 100, whatever value you get, you need to put here. So 45 divided by 30 into 100, whatever value you get, you put here. So it is I. It is I. Okay. So now I W. So it is I. Okay. So it is W. It is W. So this column is to be multiplied with this column so that you will get I W. Okay. So the I W total you will get sigma I W. Okay. So W column total is sigma W. Next, the remaining process, what you have followed in the problem type 1, the same is to be followed here. That is CPI equals to sigma IW. So sigma IW comes here. So sigma W is, that is, comes here. So therefore, CPI equals to sigma IW divided by sigma W. Whatever the answer you will get, that itself is the consumer price index number. So please understand that in the examination, you can face the problem on consumer price index number. That is two kinds of problem. This is problem type 1, so wherein the group index will not be given directly, I, that is group index, and W will be given, so you have to calculate this. In another type of problem, you will be given only weight, okay, so I will not be given, means the group index will not be given. Group index is to be calculated by using this formula, okay. So after that, you have to follow this particular process. So this is how you have to solve the problem of 5 marks. Okay, let us move towards the next slide. Right, so now we shall move towards the solution of the question paper problem. Right, so it is 2010 year question paper. So 5 marks. See here, group index is given, expenditure is given in percentage. So expenditure in percentage means this itself is the W. So now solution. So calculation of consumer price index. Okay. So group index, that is the first group column is to be entered. Next group index. So this is, that is the group index value, whatever we have, that we have to use here, that is in the group index column. Next weight. So weight, this is weight. So this is weight column. Okay. So next we have to IW, that is I into W. It is W. So it is W column. Okay. So it is I column. So it, I into W. I into W means this I column into W. That is 550 into 46. We get this figure. 215 into 10. We get this figure. 220 into 7. We get this figure. So 150 into 12. We get this figure. 275 into 25, we get this way. Okay. So this is, if you find the sum of this IW column, we get sigma IW. And the sigma, that is sum of the W column, sigma W. Okay. So consumer price index number equals to sigma IW divided by W. So here sigma IW is this one, that is 37,665. And sigma W is 100. So this comes here. That is what we have used here, 37,665 divided by 100. We get 376.65. This is the consumer price index. This is the consumer price index. It means that, so this itself is the final answer. You need not to do any further things. So, but from viewpoint of the understanding of index number, you need to understand that. So from this 376 rupees, that is 76.65, we have to deduct this 100 as a base, that is minus 100. So next we get 276.65. So it is the percent of increase of the price, of the price in these kind of commodities. Okay. Okay. Remember, this itself is enough. if you find this CPI, that is 376.65, that is enough. Just for viewpoint of understanding of index number only, I told about this deducting 100 from the consumer price index number. Whatever you will get, you know, that indicates that it is the percent of increase in the price of the commodities that are given in the question paper. Okay. So next, let us move towards the next question paper. It is 2011 question paper. So it is also the problem which we have discussed, very similar to the previous problem. So it is group, it is index, and it is expenditure in percentage. That is, it is W. So it is IW. So I into W, you get this figure. So like that, you have to multiply with every item so that you will get these every items, that is every IW. So if you get the total, you will get sigma IW, and the W column total is sigma W. So this you will put here. So this you will put here. So therefore, 11,830 divided by 100, the answer is this, that is 118.3 is the consumer price index number. If you deduct 100 from this, the percent of increase is 18.3% is the percent of increase in the price of these commodities. So this is how about the problem is to be solved. Okay, so that is, it is 2011 question paper. Now we shall move towards the next question paper. Okay, right. So see here, it is the second kind of problem what we have discussed at the beginning itself. Okay, here group is given, weight is given, but group index is not given. Okay, group index is to be calculated by us. Okay, right. So therefore, group, so calculation of consumer price index number. Okay, so now we have to prepare the table like this. So that is group column first. Okay, so next, weight column we need not to use here. First we have to use P0 P1. P0 means, see here, base year price is P0. Okay, current year price is P1. See, price, P is used for price. P is used for price. 0 is used for base year. 1 is used for current year. So therefore, base year here P0. Current year price is P1. So weight, weight is given here. Okay, weight is given in the problem itself. Okay, right. So we have taken P0, P1, and W from the problem. Okay. Now we have to calculate I. How we have to calculate I? I is to be calculated P1 divided by P0 into 100. So here P1 is 200. Okay, divided by P0 is 160. 160. Okay, into 100. So we will get 125. Likewise, we have to calculate here 60 divided by 40 into 100. We get 150. 50 divided by 25 into 100. We get 200. 10 divided by 4 into 100. We get 250. 45 divided by 30 into 100. We get 150. Okay. So it is I, it is group index. Okay, it is a group index which is not given in the problem. So therefore, we have calculated. Now we have to multiply this, okay, I column with this W column. Okay, so therefore, I into W, that is IW. Okay, IW, that is 30 into 125, 3170, sorry, 3750, 15 into 150, 2250. 15 into 200, 3000. So 20 into 250, 5000. 20 into 150, 3000. The total of which is 17,000, which is IW, that is sigma IW. So weight total is sigma W, that is 100. So therefore, this 1700 we have to use here. This 100 we have to use here. So 17,000, not 1700, 17,000 divided by 100. So answer is 170 is the consumer price index number. It implies that there is a 70% of increase in the price of these commodities that are given in the question paper. Remember, you don't write 30. So 30 is a percent of increase, but the consumer price index is 170 itself. Okay, if you write this much, okay, till this process, that itself is enough to get the marks. Okay, right. Next question paper 2013. Okay, so here also it is very similar to the previous problem what we have solved. Okay, so it is group, it is weight, so it is price. So 2011 year price becomes P naught, 2012 year price becomes P1. Okay, see here, latest year becomes 1, so early year becomes 0. So therefore P naught, P1, and weight is given in the problem, that is W. Okay, so we have to calculate I. So as I said, P1 divided by P0 into 100, we will get these values. Next, I column is to be multiplied with W. So this into this, okay, this into this, that is 30 into 120, we get this. 15 into 125, we get this. 20 into 110, we get this. 10 into 150, we get this. Okay, 25 into 120, we get this, that is 3000. Total is 12,175, which is sigma IW. The sigma W is 100. So therefore, consumer price index number equals to sigma IW divided by sigma W. Sigma IW is 12,175. Okay, sigma W is 100. That is 12,175 divided by 100 is equals to consumer price index number equals to 121.75. Okay, it implies that there is an increase of price by 21%.75. Okay, so next we shall move towards the next question. So that is, it is 2014 question paper. Okay, so here also it is very similar to the previous problem what we have solved. Here also group index is not given, we have to calculate. So therefore it is group. Okay, so it is base year, that is P0. It is current year, that is P1. So it is weight, okay, that is W. I is not given. I is to be calculated by us like P1 divided by P0 into 100. P1 is 3000 divided by P0 2400 into 100. We will get 125. Like that we have to calculate for other items. Okay. Next, I into W. That is, this is I. So this is W. Okay. So this into this, that is 30 into 125, we get this. 15 into 125, we get this. 20 into 150, we get this. 10 into 120, we get 1200. 25 into 150, we get this. Okay. So the total is 13,575 is sigma IW. Okay. Sigma W is 100. So therefore, consumer price index number equals to 13,575 divided by 100. So which is equals to 135.75 is the answer. It implies that if you deduct 100 from this, that is, if you deduct the 100 base from 135.75, so there is a 35.75, that is 35.75% of increase in the price of these commodities that are given in the problem. But on the answer 135.75, this itself is enough to get the full 5 marks. Okay, right. So next is 2015 question paper problem. It is very simple because group index is directly given in the problem. Okay, so very simple. You need not to calculate I, that is P1 divided by P0 in 100. You need not to calculate because it is already given in the problem, that is group index. So therefore, group you take here, group index you take here, expenditure in percentage, it is W. Okay, so therefore it is I. Okay, it is W. So I into W means, so this column into this column, that is 350 into 15, you get this. 200 into 21, you get 4200. 240 into 21, you get this. 160 into 31, you get this. 250 into 22, you get this. Okay, so total this, you will get 24,950. So which is nothing but it is sigma IW. So the total here is 110, not 100. So sigma W is 110. Okay, so therefore 24,950 divided by 100, is equals to 226.86 is the consumer price index number. Okay, right. So let us see the question paper 2016. Okay, carrying 5 marks. Okay, so here group index is not given, only group is given, weight is given, but group index is not given, but base year price and current year price is given. So therefore we have to calculate this I here, that is I. Okay, so it is group. Okay, okay, so 14 is the base year, so P naught. 15 is the current year, so it is P1. Okay, so that is latest year become P1. Okay, okay, so next W is given in the problem, this column is given in the problem. Okay, it is I you have to calculate, that is P1 divided by P0 into 100. So here P1 is 300, P0 is 250. 300 divided by 250 into 100, we get 120. So like that we have to calculate for remaining items. Okay, so it is I column. Okay, it is I column, it is W column. So therefore IW means I into W or W into I, that is 30 into 120, 3600, 15 into 125, 1875, 20 into 110, 2200, 10 into 150, 1500, 25 into 120, 3000. The total of which is sigma IW, that is 12,175. The sigma W is 100. Okay, so sigma W we have to take here, that is consumer price index number equal to sigma IW divided by sigma W. So sigma W is, that is sigma IW is 12,175 and W, that is sigma W is 100. So here consumer price index number equals to 121.75. So next, move towards the 2018 question paper. So here it is very simple. So group index is also given, weight is also, means I is given, W is given. Only we have to multiply total and divided by, okay, right. So that is, it is group, it is index column, it is weight column. So it is I into W, that is 120 into 30, we get this. 140 into 15, we get this. 112 into 20, we get this. 116 into 10, we get this. Okay, 106 into 25, we get this. The total is called as sigma IW. So 100 is the sigma W. So therefore consumer price index number is equal to 11,810 divided by 100. So consumer price index number is 118.1. Okay, this itself is the answer. It implies that if you deduct 100 from this, 18.1% is the rise of the price, means 18.1% is rise in the price of these commodities that are given in the question paper. Okay, so it is about how the 5 marks questions are to be solved by the students. So I hope you understood about all the solutions. Okay, so in detail solutions are done in the index number second video. Okay, so you can watch that video also, so that you will be able to understand the 5 marks question, how the 5 marks questions are to be solved very clearly. Okay, okay, thank you, thank you one and all.